Bubble versus Appgyver. We're going to look at the key features, pricing, and which platform I would choose. Bubble is a powerful no-code platform where you can create pretty much anything. A dashboard, a marketplace, micro SaaS, you name it, you can do it with Bubble. Appgyver is the world's first professional no-code platform. You can create mobile apps, apps for your desktop, browser, and TV. You have to decide for yourself, what are you trying to create? So write down in the comment section down below or a piece of paper, what are you trying to create? What do you need for your app? Now let's go a little bit deeper with the features for Bubble. Number one, you can build any web app with no code. It's going to give you a blank canvas to start creating. So really, depending on what you're trying to do and what's in your mind, you can start building that out with Bubble. Now, there's pros and cons with that blank canvas and starting there. You do have to understand the functionality and how to use Bubble, but depending on what you're trying to create, a micro SaaS, a marketplace, you can do all of those things. If you want inspiration, take a look at what you can create using the template with zero code, or check out Stephen Campbell and what he's doing, or Lee Launches, or any of those guys to see what you can be doing with Bubble. It's pretty incredible. It allows you to customize the UX the way that you want it. You can manage the data and the accounts. This is really important. So instead of worrying about you need to be on another platform to manage your information, that database, you can do that with Bubble right there on the same platform. And you can integrate in tons of different ways. If you have experience using APIs, you can do that. You can use the different Bubble plugins in the marketplace. All of those things are at your fingertips. It's also important to note the hosting. The infrastructure is very good. So you can just worry about your app, what you're trying to create, and the infrastructure is going to be able to withstand the heavy traffic and as you're scaling your brand. You can also have collaborations using Bubble as well. You can have up to 40 collaborators with your app. Let's look at the key features for Appgyver. You can have native performance, you can have unlimited logic, and you can do this visually. So you can actually break down what different buttons will do, how it interacts with the app, or what you're going to be adding to the database. You can do all of those steps visually. You can have over 500 components, and you have a powerful theme engine. And this allows you to have a large library of user interface components that are helpful for you, and you can mix and match them. And you can integrate APIs within minutes. So similar to Bubble, you can also have the power of APIs for your app. Let's look at pricing. For Bubble, you can start for free. You can have a limited experience, but you can still get started. For example, for the server capacity, it starts with basic. The branding and SEO, you're going to have Bubble branding, but that's okay because for free, you can start with your MVP, your minimal viable product, test it out, see what's going on, but you're going to have that Bubble branding to begin with. For the password protection, it's going to be editor only. The application editors, you're going to have one, and the logs is 30 minutes. The file storage, this is important, 0.5 gigs, and you're going to have support from the community, which is huge. You can get so much value from the community, and the monthly price, free. Now, moving over to the personal plan, you can have access to live versions, custom domains, the branding and SEO, that's going to be white labeling. This is really when you're going to be looking to establish yourself, the startup or a side hustle, and you're going to be having it your own personal branding, and it's going to be lean or, you know, just very concise, and it's going to be all your branding. That's going to be personal right there. You're going to have password protection for editor and the run mode. You're going to be able to import and export CSV. That's important if you're going to be having different records that you're going to need to export or import for your project. That's really crucial. For the data backup and restore last 7 days, I would say that's a must just in case something happens, and logs 24 hours. To note, this is a big thing right here. File storage is expanding to 10 gigs and you can have support via email. To do all of that, that's going to be $25 annually or $29 month to month. Let's go to the professional plan. The main difference is you can have 3 reserve units for the server capacity, the ability to add capacity up to 7 units. If we look at the scheduled workflow, now we can have a run daily instead of run monthly, multiple development versions, 2 versions here, application editors, 2. So we're having 1 increase, the logs 14 days, our storage is going to be going up to 20 gigs. And now the professional plan, that would be 115 annually, 129 per month. For production level, then we're going to be looking at the server capacity at 10 reserve units, ability to add capacity up to 30 units, the multiple development versions, 20, 15 application editors, and you're going to be able to have a backup and restore for the last year. And now we're going to get even more file storage up to 50 gigs, and we get priority email support. As we're backing up and looking at the pricing, this really depends on where you're going to be. Is this just an idea and you want to test it out? Well, you can start for free. If you're looking to needing CSV import-export, or you're going to need more storage, now we're starting at more personal or professional. What I've seen in the past, which I really like, check out Stephen Campbell. I have a whole video, me talking to him as he built Virtual Ghostwriter. You know, you can start with these where you can give yourself a time limit. See if you can make your money or be able to sell a micro SaaS or a product within 30 days to make it worth your while. If you can't make the money, you know, perhaps you need to pivot or it's not the right time. But that's something I really like to really incentivize you and to see if you have validation very quickly. You can do that within 30 days of using Bubble. Let's look at the pricing for Appgyver and the different tiers. And the tiers are, they're all free. That's right, Appgyver, the entire platform you can be using this version, it is free. Doesn't matter how much revenue you're making. In the past, you would have to be charged a certain amount if you're making a certain amount of revenue. From October 2021 on, it is now free to use. That's really enticing and a lot of people love it. Listen, I love free, but there's a cost to that as well. Let's talk about which one I would choose. As we look at Bubble or Appgyver, which platform I would choose, I'm gonna go with Bubble. The reason behind it is they have an incredible team and community. If you need something, just go on just Twitter or anywhere, people will answer your question. Go into the Bubble forums, people are so nice, and there are so many builders, creators that are trying to help you. I'm not joking. This is an insane community. On the flip side, I would just like to say Bubble has probably the steepest learning curve for a no-code platform. You're going to have to take several weeks or months to be able to be proficient, and then it will take you more time to master it. But once you get there, you're going to be able to basically create any kind of micro SaaS business or any kind of platform you want, once you understand the fundamental in the workflow. And having the community be so prolific and people trying to help, and the increase of so many plugins, there's very few platforms like this in the no-code space. It will cost money to build on this platform, and you will have to figure out if you're going to be having a revenue source from subscriptions or how you're going to be paying for this long term, this project. That's just the price of business. That's just what's going to happen. Versus on Appgyver, I do see a lot of people that want to use this platform, and it is very enticing because it's free. And perhaps to get started, it could be very enticing, especially if you're on a limited budget. Problem is, number one, the team pretty much, if you read anything in the message boards or the forums or the Facebook groups or anything you want, they're pretty much not building out any of the features for the foreseeable future. For the last 2 years, looking at Appgyver, all of their advancements of templates, what they plan on doing, is pretty much at a standstill. And looking at different experts that you can hire for Appgyver, there are not a lot of them. I just haven't seen it. And if I'm wrong, in the comment section, let me know if you're like, hey, I'm an Appgyver developer. Let me know, because I will give you so much business. So many people ask me questions. I won't build on the platform. I won't build on it because none of the templates that I want going forward and the level of scalability I want, it's not there yet. I'm just not putting my time and energy into it. But if you really like this platform and you want to do this, let me know. We'll hook you up with business, all of those things. Let me know in the comment section. Another big update that I would like to mention is, now that it's free, the database that used to be offered for Appgyver is gone. You have to use a third-party database. So you have to use Backendless, Xano, things like that, to be able to hook in to using Appgyver. Now that's a problem, because before it was free up to a couple million dollars, I think, in revenue, but you had a database built in, kind of like Bubble. But now that's gone. There's no database there, so you have to pay for a database in some form. So if I'm looking at it, yeah, it's free, but is it free? I mean, it's free when you're using a lot of the functionality, but how many advanced apps don't rely on a database in some way? So to me, I'm gonna be leaning on Bubble or other platforms that already have that integrated, or a way for me to really scale my app, because you need data, you need a database. So with all those considerations, I'm leaning on Bubble. In the comment section down below, which one do you want to use and why? And if you're interested in making multiple streams of income, we have a whole video, 6 ways how to do this online today. If you like these kind of videos, make sure that you like and subscribe. We do this every single week. I'll see you in the next video.